Spherical mirrors, concave mirror and convex mirror. Firstly, let me teach you that what are spherical mirrors. Well, a section sliced from the surface of a sphere and polished at one side is called spherical mirror. For example, consider this sphere of a glass. Or we can say that it is a ball of glass. Now I select two parts of this sphere, this part and this part. I take this part of the sphere. We know that glass is a transparent object. Now to make this part of the glass as a mirror, the outside surface is polished using a layer of silver. This spherical mirror is called convex mirror. If I ask you, what is convex mirror? Your answer is, a spherical mirror whose outer surface is polished is called convex mirror. Let me repeat it. A spherical mirror whose outer surface is polished is called convex mirror. Remember that this is the reflecting surface of a convex mirror and this dashed part is the backside of a convex mirror. Secondly, I take this part of the sphere. We know that it is a glass or transparent object. Now to make it as a mirror, the inside surface of the mirror is polished. After polishing, it will reflect light. This spherical mirror is called concave mirror. If I ask you, what is a concave mirror? Your answer is, a spherical mirror whose inner surface is polished is called concave mirror. Let me repeat it. A spherical mirror whose inner surface is polished is called concave mirror. Remember that this is the reflecting surface of a concave mirror and this dashed part is the backside of a concave mirror. Thus note it down that in convex mirrors, the outside surface is polished, while in concave mirrors, the inside surface is polished. Also, let me teach you that why concave and convex mirrors are called spherical mirrors. It is because both concave and convex mirrors came from a sphere, and they both are made out of a sphere. So they are therefore called spherical mirrors. Now the easy trick to remember the concave and convex mirrors is the spoon. The upper part of the spoon is just like a concave mirror and the lower part of the spoon is just like a convex mirror. You can do this simple experiment at your home by looking into the upper and lower part of the spoon in order to see your face image in it. Now let me teach you the characteristics of a concave and convex mirrors. Let's consider concave and convex mirror. We know that concave mirror is a part of a sphere and convex mirror is also a part of a sphere. Thus, I draw these imaginary spheres around them. Firstly, what is center of curvature? The center of a sphere is called center of curvature. It is represented by C. In case of concave mirror, this is the center of a sphere. So it is the center of curvature of a concave mirror. While in case of a convex mirror, this is the center of a sphere. So it is also the center of curvature of a convex mirror. Secondly, what is pole or vertex? The midpoint of a mirror is called pole or vertex. It is represented by P. For example, this is the midpoint of the concave mirror, so it is the pole or vertex of a concave mirror. While this is the midpoint of a convex mirror, so it is the pole or vertex of a convex mirror. Thirdly, what is radius of a curvature? The radius of a sphere is called radius of a curvature. It is represented by R. For example, the distance between the center of curvature C and pole P is called radius of the curvature R of a concave mirror, while the distance between the center of a curvature C and pole P is called radius of the curvature of a convex mirror. Fourthly, what is principal axis? The straight line that passes through the center and pole is called principal axis. For example, this line passing through the center of a curvature C and pole P is called principal axis of the concave mirror, while this line passing through the center of a curvature C and pole P is called principal axis of the convex mirror. Fifthly, what is focal point? The point lies halfway between the center of curvature and pole is called focal point. It is represented by capital F. For example, this is the point between center of curvature and pole, so it is the focal point F of the concave mirror. This is also the point between center of curvature and pole, so it is the focal point F of a convex mirror. Sixthly, what is focal length? The distance from the pole P to focal point F or the distance from the center to the focal point is called focal length. It is represented by small f. Focal length F is equal to 1/2 of the radius. For example, this is the focal length F of a concave mirror and this is the focal length F of a convex mirror. If the radius of a concave mirror R is equal to 10 mm, then its focal length F is equal to 5 mm. If the radius of a convex mirror R is equal to 8 mm, then its focal length F is equal to 4 mm. So focal length F is equal to 1/2 of radius. Here, let me teach you two conceptual MCQs. Firstly, center of a curvature and focal point lie at the same side of a reflecting surface of a concave mirror. While center of curvature and focal point lie at opposite side of the reflecting surface of a convex mirror. Secondly, principal axis intersects the mirror at 90 degrees. Hence, note down these MCQs. Finally, why concave mirrors are called as converging mirrors and why convex mirrors are called as diverging mirrors? Well, the word converge means come together or join together. Consider a concave mirror. When light beam falls on a concave mirror, after reflection, all the light rays join together or converge at one point. So we say that concave mirrors converge the light beam at one point. They are therefore called as converging mirrors. Secondly, the word diverge means move in different direction or spread out. Consider a convex mirror. When light beam falls on it, after reflection, all the rays spread out in different direction or diverge. So we say that convex mirrors diverge the beam of light. They are therefore called as diverging mirror. So concave mirrors are converging mirrors and convex mirrors are diverging mirrors. To learn more about ray diagram of concave and convex mirrors, watch our next lecture and its link will be given in the description. I hope that you have understood all these concepts.